I recently got access to the private beta of GPT-3. I was excited after seeing what GPT-3 is able to do, such as writing code, talking like a philosopher, deciphering legal documents, writing emails and fictions. It looks like a powerful API. It makes me curious about how to bring GPT-3's amazing ability to cybersecurity. So for this video, I brought File Descriptor with me to work on this together. Before we get started, let me quickly give a shout out to our sponsor, Integrity. Integrity is an ethical hacking platform. Sign up using the link below to become an ethical hacker today. File Descriptor. Given GPT-3 is capable of consuming unstructured data, where should we start applying this in security?
Let's start with a fun example. As a bug bounty hunter, we spend quite some time writing reports. We can train GPT-3 to ease this process. For example, we can try to have the bot generate an impact for a given title. To do this, we provide a list of known impacts from HackOne publicly disclosed reports and provide their titles. Let's test it by leaving the last one blank and see how it goes. It doesn't look 100% accurate, but with more training data, it can get more accurate.
Hey, this actually reminds me of HackOne's managed service. The service is about whenever a program receives a spam report, they can flag it as a spam automatically. I would imagine HackOne spends a lot of time coding this automation. Do you think we can use this API to do the same with just a few examples?
Yes, we can use GPT-3 to classify spam reports. Similar to what we did in the previous example, we just need to feed it some spam reports, as well as legit reports as samples, and it can quickly determine if an incoming report is legit or not. Ron, what else do you think we can do with GPT-3 besides writing or handling bug reports?
What about we use this API to catch false positives? Because one of the problems that static code analysis has is that the scanning results have a lot of false positives. Sometimes the true positive findings could be buried among the sea of false positives. If we can somehow use a few examples to teach this API what is real findings and what is not, then it could save a lot of costs of reviewing all the false positives manually. The idea is simple. We give it a few examples for real findings and false positive findings, and show the API the expected analysis for the findings. And hopefully they will come up with a correct analysis. Let's start with a simple example. Hard-coded sensitive information. This one gives a lot of false positives because usually the scanner scans for variable names, but not the value. Here, we give them a few examples of placeholder value and the real AWS secrets, and tell the API which findings are real, and then we hit submit. Hey, the result looks pretty good. Given we have just added a few lines of code, it can easily determine what are false positives and what are the real findings. If we go a step further, SQL injection, then the result isn't so satisfactory. The logic I've presented here is easy. If the user input has been validated before passing to the query, then the code is not vulnerable to SQL injection. Hey, so you can see the result is not very accurate here. What do you think, File Descriptor?
I think for this to work, we need to provide better inputs, like the surrounding code instead of just the code the scanner spotted. The reason it works so well on finding sensitive information is it doesn't need to know context. It just needs to find high entropy data. Anyway, GPT-3 doesn't really replace tools that are designed for specific tasks, but it is a fun and quick way to get inspiration. For example, give it a list of permission descriptions and find contradictions.
Interesting idea. This reminds me of an old Shopify bug I found earlier. There is a subtle logic flaw in the documentation, and later it turns into a $500 bounty reward. The logic flaw is simple. Multipass allows anyone with a secret key to access any customer's account in Shopify, and the staff members with settings permission are able to read the Multipass secret key value, but only staff members with customer permissions are able to access customer accounts. Clearly, this contradicts itself. So I wrote this down in the prompt, and later I crafted a fake scenario and see if GPT-3 can spot the logic flaw. As you can see, I have to try multiple times to get there. But the fact that it can actually provide an accurate statement of the logic flaw is impressive. Thank you for watching. Leave a comment below if you have anything that you want us to test with GPT-3. It doesn't have to be related to security. And we will pick some interesting ideas and show you the result in the next video.